In this video, I will give you a variety of conic section equations in general form. And we're going to have to convert them into standard form by completing the square. But first, we will need to identify which conic section it is. Is it going to be a parabola, a circle, an ellipse, or a hyperbola? But first of all, if all you see is a general form equation, like you see in number one and number two, the first thing you need to understand is all you really have to pay attention to in terms of classification are the squared terms, x squared or y squared. The rest of the terms don't matter in terms of just identifying which one of these four things it is. So let me just quickly go through a few clues that will help you immediately identify what shape you're looking at. For a parabola, you're only going to have one variable squared. Okay, so for example, you might have 3x squared. And then that'll be the only thing squared. You know, maybe the y term is just a 2y. But you're only going to have one variable squared. You know it's a parabola. For the rest of these, all of the rest of these, you're going to have both variables squared, x squared and y squared. So I'll just say for all three of these, you're going to have an x squared and a y squared. So the rest of this is going to be about the coefficients of the x squared and the y squared. For a circle, both coefficients are the same. So for example, if I had 3x squared plus 3y squared, okay, then I would know that I'm looking at a circle. For an ellipse, you have different coefficients, but the signs have to be the same. So for example, I'm going to go back to this. Say if I had 3x squared, and then I had 2y squared. Okay, so they're both squared, and the coefficients are different. If these were both 3s, it would be a circle, but I have a 3 and a 2. That's what makes it an ellipse. Now, it's important that they have the same sign. Either they're both positive or they're both negative. Because, as you can, as you're about to see, if the signs are different, that's going to make it a hyperbola. So if the coefficients of the x squared and y squared have different signs, then it's going to be a hyperbola. For example, if I had 3x squared minus 2y squared, that would make this a hyperbola. Or if it was negative 3x squared and a positive 2y squared. If the signs are different, then that automatically makes it a hyperbola. So problem number one. First of all, I know that this is going to be a circle. Let's just write that down. In fact, I think I'll go through all the problems and classify them. This will be a circle because I have two squared terms, and the coefficients are both one. So that makes it a circle. Look at problem number two. This is going to be a parabola. I know this because only one variable is squared. Okay, look at problem number three. This is going to be an ellipse. I know this because I have two terms squared. They're both positive, but the coefficients are different, 3 and 2. If they were both like 3 and 3, it would be a circle, but they're different, so it's an ellipse. This one is going to be a hyperbola. I know this because I have the two squared terms, and one of them is positive and one of them is negative. If you have two different signs on the squared terms, it's a hyperbola. Number five, this is another parabola. because only one variable is squared. This is another circle, because I have two variables squared and the coefficients are the same. They're both 1. This is another circle for the same reason. I have two variables squared. The coefficients are the same. They're both 1. This is another ellipse. I have two variables squared. They're both positive. The coefficients are different. I have a coefficient of 1 and a coefficient of 4. Since they're not the same, it's an ellipse. So back to number 1. This is a circle. We're going to complete the square. So we need to group together the x terms and the y terms. So these x terms need to be grouped, and the y terms need to be grouped. The constant needs to go over there. So I'm going to have x squared plus 10x, and then plus y squared plus 12y is equal to 5. Now I'm going to complete the square. Half the middle squared. Half of this is 5. 5 squared is 25. So I add a 25. I've got to put it on both sides. Half the middle squared. Half of this is 6. Square that, I get 36. I have to put it on both sides. If I factor this, I'm going to get x plus 5 twice. So x plus 5 squared. If I factor this, I'm going to get y plus 6 squared. And this is going to equal 66. So this is the standard form equation of this circle. Problem number 2. Since the x is squared, I'm going to keep the x terms on the left side of the equation. Everything else needs to go to the right side of the equation. So I will have x squared plus 4x equals 9y plus 5. Now I complete the square. Half the middle squared. Half of this is 2. 2 squared is 4. So I need to add 4 to both sides. If I factor this, I will have x plus 2 squared. And over here I have 9y plus 9. So I have x plus 2 squared, and I'm going to factor out the 9, so I'll have 9 times y plus 1. This is the standard form equation of my parabola. Let's move on to problem number 3, this ellipse. I need to group together my x terms and my y terms, but, well, I guess they were already grouped together, so now I feel silly. In order to complete the square, I need to factor the coefficient in front of the squared term outside of parentheses. So I'm going to take out that 3, so I have to divide everything by 3, so I'll have x squared plus 6x, leave space to complete the square. I have to factor out this 2, so I'll bring the 2 out front, divide everything by 2, so I'll have y squared minus 8y, leave space to complete the square, is equal to negative 53. Time to complete the square. Half the middle squared. Half of this is 3. Square it, you've got 9. But, oh wait, it's really 3 times 9. That's 27. So I'm going to put a plus 27 over there. Now I need to complete the square with the y's. Half of this is negative 4. Square it, that's positive 16. Oh wait, it's really 2 times 16. That's 32. So I need to add 32 to the other side. If I factor this, I'm going to get x plus 3 twice. In other words, x plus 3 squared. Similarly, here I will have y minus 4 squared. Add all these up. These all add up to 6. The standard form equation of an ellipse has a 1 over here. So that's why I need to, that's why I need to divide by 6. So I will get a 1. So divide everything by 6. 3 goes into 6 twice, so this will be x plus 3 squared over 2. 2 goes into 6 3 times, so this will be y minus 4 squared over 3 is equal to 1. Let's see if I can make this into a better 3. So this is the standard form equation of my ellipse. Let's take a look at this hyperbola. So I need to group together my x terms and my y terms. I need to put the positive squared term first. So I'm going to put y squared in the front, followed by the x's. This 55 got to go. So, like I said, I'm going to put the y's first because the y squared term is positive. So I will have 4y squared, and then minus 40y, and then minus 9x squared, and minus 18x equals negative 55. Ka-chow. So I need to factor out this 4 outside of parentheses. In other words, divide by 4. So I will have y squared minus 10y, leave space to complete the square. I need to factor out this negative 9 outside of parentheses. In other words, divide by negative 9. So that's going to give me plus 2x, leave space to complete the square, is equal to negative 55. Now it's time to complete the square. Half the middle squared. Half of this is negative 5. Square it. You have a 25. Oh, wait. This is really 4 times 25. That's 100. So that's why I'm going to add 100 over there. Complete the square. Half the middle squared. Half of this is 1. Square it is still 1. But oh wait, this is really negative 9 times 1. That's a negative 9, which I will put on the other side. Factoring time. It's factoring time. So this is going to be 4 times, and this will be y minus 5 twice. And then minus 9 times, and this will be x plus 1 twice. Equals, now I have to add up these three numbers. So that's 36. For the standard form equation of a hyperbola, this needs to be a 1 right here. So that's why I know, whoops, I need to divide everything by 36. All right, so I just need to reduce this down and then I'll be done. 4 goes into 36 9 times, so that gives me y minus 5 squared over 9. And then similarly, I will have x plus 1 squared over 4 is equal to 1. Boom! There's the standard form equation of my hyperbola. Okay, check out number 5. Since the y is squared, the y terms are going to stay on the left-hand side. Everything else needs to go to the right-hand side. So I'm going to have 2y squared plus 16y. And then on the other side, I will have positive 16x minus 32, and then the minus 96 that was already there. But so I just moved these two things over and they became the opposite side because I added and I subtracted. Anyway, I'm going to have to factor this 2 out. Maybe not. Let me wait for a second. So I have 2y squared plus 16y. Let me go ahead and combine these like terms. So this is minus 128. Alright, I just combined these like terms. Now, I can't have this 2 sitting here for standard form, not even in front of parentheses. But I'm noticing that all 4 terms are divisible by 2. So let's just divide both sides of the equation by 2. In other words, let's divide every single term by 2. So that's going to give me y squared plus 8y is equal to 8x minus, what's that, 64? Now I can complete the square. Half the middle squared. Half of this is 4. 4 squared is 16. I need to add 16 to both sides. If I factor this, I'm going to get y plus 4 squared. Meanwhile, over here, I have 8x minus 48. Now I need to factor out that 8, so I will have y plus 4 squared is equal to 8 times x minus 6. So that's it. This is the standard form equation of this parabola. How about this circle? I need to group my x terms together, and I'm going to need to group my y terms together. So that's why I will have x squared plus 18x, and then plus y squared minus 10y is equal to negative 90. Now I can complete the square. Half the middle squared. Half of this is 9. 9 squared is 81. So I must add 81 to both sides. Complete the square again. Half of this is negative 5. Negative 5 squared is positive 25. So I must add 25 to both sides. If I factor the x part, I'm going to get x plus 9 squared. If I factor the y part, I'm going to get y minus 5 squared. Add up these three numbers. I get 16. And there is my standard form equation of the circle. Okay, we have another circle. So once again, I need to group my x terms and my y terms, but I noticed that they are already grouped, so I'm good to go. So I have x squared plus 2x, I'm just going to space them out a little. Plus y squared plus 2y is equal to 2. So I'm going to just complete the square. Half the middle squared. Half of this is 1. 1 squared is 1. So I add 1 to the other side. Half of this is 1. 1 squared is 1. So I add 1 to the other side. When I factor this, I'm going to have x plus 1 squared. When I factor this, I'm going to have y plus 1 squared. When I add these, I have 4, and that is my standard form equation of the circle. Here's an ellipse. I need to group my x terms together, and I need to group my y terms together. So I'm going to have x squared plus 10x, and then I will have plus 4y squared plus 24y is equal to negative 45. So here I will have x squared plus 10x plus, right now I'm taking out the coefficient of the y squared term. That has to come outside of parentheses, so I'm dividing by 4, so I'll have y squared plus 6y, leave space to complete the square, is equal to negative 45. Now I'm going to complete the square. So half the middle squared, half of this is 5, 5 squared is 25, so I add 25 to the other side. Let's complete the square again. Half of this is 3, 3 squared is 9, so I'm going to put plus 9. But oh wait, this is really 4 times 9. This is 36. So I'm going to add 36 to the other side for that one. If I factor this, I'm going to end up with x plus 5 squared. And then I've got this 4. And then if I factor this, I'm going to have y plus 3 squared. So I just need to add these three numbers together. So that is going to be 16. For an ellipse, I need a 1 over here. That's why I'm going to divide everything by 16, so I can get a 1. So now I just have to reduce these two terms, and that'll be my final answer. So I will still have x plus 5 squared over 16. But 4 goes into 16 4 times, so I will have y plus 3 squared over 4 equals 1. And there it is. Here's the standard form equation of this ellipse. All right, guys, that's going to do it for this video. Go ahead and click here in the red apple to watch the next video. Click in the green apple to subscribe, or click the yellow apple for the full playlist.